An American Screen Actors Guild stands with Hollywood writers whose strike for fair compensation has stretched past its first month. Our North America correspondent Steve Angeles has that story.
Hollywood led the charge as thousands of union workers marched the streets of downtown Los Angeles last week. The Writers Guild of America, which represents television and movie writers, has been on strike for nearly a month as they continue negotiating with studios over their wages, royalty payments, and the use of artificial intelligence.
The bosses, management, corporations, they must share the wealth that we helped create.
But the writers may not be alone for much longer, as SAG-AFTRA, which represents actors and actresses like Joy Regulano, has also voted to authorize a strike. IATSE, which handles crews, and the Directors Guild of America are also nearing their contract negotiations. Many of the same issues are expected to be on the bargaining tables for all these workers that are a part of one of California's largest industries.
It's like already tough in normal times, and it's just only getting worse, so we gotta stop it now before things just get out of control with AI and streaming and all the ways that we're getting taken advantage of, all of us.
It's not just workers in showbiz turning up the heat. Other industries such as hotel, hospitality, and education are also nearing contract negotiations. Earlier this year, school support staff went on strike.
The balance of money and power is just all off, so we're just like, we gotta fix things or it's only gonna get worse.
As writers continue hitting the streets and rallying outside of television studios, the Alliance of Motion Picture and Television Producers, which represents major studios, has said that it offered, quote, generous increases in compensation to writers. However, there has been no schedules for talks between the writers and the studios.
There's no telling how long work stoppages in Hollywood will last. With many episodes in the can, viewers may not feel it for a few more months. However, when it's time for new seasons of different shows to come out, they may notice a delay. Steve Angeles, ABS-CBN News, Los Angeles.
Now, over in the United States, a highway in Texas turns into a roaring river as heavy rainfall caused flash floods in the city of O'Donnell. Several vehicles can be seen pushed to the side of the highway, with some cars submerged in surging flood water. On Thursday, authorities advised residents to stay off main roads and move to higher ground as the National Weather Service issued flash flood alerts across southern Texas. The National Economic and Development Authority says its board, which is chaired by President Marcos, has approved some key infrastructure projects, and that includes the Tarlac-Pangasinan-La Union Expressway, or TP-LEX extension project. NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan shares this is considered as one of the fastest unsolicited proposal approvals. The project is a 59-kilometer expressway which seeks to connect the Ilocos region to Central Luzon and Metro Manila. Balisacan notes the project will be implemented through a public-private partnership.
Recall, these high-impact infrastructure projects are designed to address the nation's infrastructure deficit, thereby driving sustainable economic growth across priority sectors of our economy. In total, the IFPs have an estimated cost of 8.3 trillion pesos. The Marcos administration remains steadfast in its dedication to pursuing projects that are in line with its 8-point socioeconomic agenda and the strategies identified in the Philippine Development Plan 2023 to 2028.